Arizona state lawmakers have accused Maricopa County officials of deleting election data, but a contractor found that data, and it looks like it may have never been missing in the first place. The accusations came after Republicans in the state Senate demanded an audit of last year's election results, which started last month. 2020 was the first time a Democrat has won Arizona in the presidential race since 1996. For more on this, I want to bring in Andrew Oxford. He's a reporter who covers politics for the Arizona Republic newspaper. Andrew, great to see you. So explain where this claim came from, and was a database of election data really deleted?
Right. If you've been hearing anything about this at all, you've probably heard about the recount of 2.1 million ballots, the 2.1 million ballots that were cast by Maricopa County voters last year. You've probably seen, you know, the photos like what you were just seeing of people poring over these ballots by hand. But this process also involves the review of election equipment, software, computer data that county officials use to administer the election. The contractors hired by the Senate said last week that some of the computer files, a directory, I think, of files had been deleted by the county, and even accused the county of spoliation of evidence. And you can see it there. This was actually first raised on the Twitter account of the audit, not by senators themselves, but with this tweet. And that was a pretty explosive claim to lodge on Twitter. The county responded that they hadn't deleted anything, that I've heard from some election officials who said that this is actually not an uncommon error, or at least an error that could easily happen with the kind of system that they're working with. And they put forward an explanation of where these files might have gone, you know, where they could be found. And sure enough, on Tuesday, the Senate had a meeting with top Republicans and some of their contractors, some of the people involved in the audit. And their contractors said that actually they had found the data. They had recovered it, is what they had said, but did not explain if they had found it before or after the county put forward its explanation of what might have happened and where to find it.
I think this is so interesting, because so often when these sort of theories are thrown out there about, you know, issues with voting, you have to sort of prove a negative almost, you know. Well, how can you prove that they didn't come from a foreign country and weren't flown in? And so it's sort of a thing that it's very difficult to prove something, prove some of these theories wrong. But here's a case where the theory is clearly proven wrong. They're not, you know, this information is not missing. I'm curious about that Tuesday meeting. Can you just tell me a little more details about how it went and what the reaction was when it was revealed that, no, we have this information?
It was an unusual meeting. It wasn't a hearing of any legislative committee. There, you know, some Republican senators had been threatening, or rather lawyers for Republican senators had been threatening to issue subpoenas, to compel county officials to come and testify in front of the Senate or a committee about various aspects, I guess, of the election. They backed down from that. They didn't ultimately issue subpoenas. Instead, they invited county officials to attend a meeting. County officials declined and have really drawn a line that they're not interested in participating any further in this. They feel like the Senate is really acting in bad faith here and didn't want to participate any further. The Senate president, the chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee here, went ahead with a meeting anyway with two of their contractors as well as their liaison in the process. The meeting was closed. Press couldn't go. Democrats weren't invited. One instance, I think some Democrats tried to go and were asked to leave. And really, it was a status update, I guess, of the audit. They, you know, came to this point that they found the data, discussed that seemed to be a moot point at the moment, and discussed how to proceed. Counting, you have to remember, began on April 23rd, was expected to end by mid-May. It's on hold for a week right now and is now expected to go through June. So that was kind of where things were left off. It's unclear on, you know, if that's going to be a feasible timeline. The contractors said that they could get it done in that period of time, but things are already kind of running past schedule.
So the Senate president called a meeting to address these issues on Tuesday. What's going on there? How is the Senate president reacting to the data being located?
Some senators have maintained that this doesn't clear the county of any wrongdoing. They said the county, the contractor says that it was deleted. They stand by that. So they, aren't really endeavoring to, patch things up with the county. There's no retraction of accusing them of any wrongdoing or anything like that. At this point, it really feels like you have, the county government, which administered the election, and the Senate really kind of talking past each other. They're no longer really cooperating on this, if they were cooperating at all. And it's kind of reached a strange point where they're really just talking past each other now.
Okay, so the Maricopa County Board of Supervisors is like, enough, let's just end this audit. I want to play a clip from a news conference on Monday.
I believe that Joe Biden won the election. All right. And the reason that I feel confident in saying that, particularly in Maricopa County, is that we overturned every stone. And we have professionals, both with the early voting and the election day voting. They did everything right. We asked the difficult questions. All right. And we certified the election back in November. But now it's time to say enough is enough.
So we should point out here that pretty much everyone's, they're all Republicans almost. The Board of Supervisors is heavily Republican, but they're completely at odds with the state Senate on the election results. What is the difference in their politics here, and why don't they agree on this?
This really started, you have to remember, this whole process really got underway almost right after the election. Joe Biden's victory was obviously really significant in Arizona politics, given the state's political history. And so there's been this ongoing effort by some Republican legislators to first, throw out the results, get Congress not to accept our Electoral College slate. And that's kind of transformed into this, into what we're seeing now, this audit. But, there have been a number of Republicans who've raised concerns about kind of going down this road. And among them have been county officials who have overseen the election, who have helped run the election, and who have really defended the process and have touted it as working in a pretty bipartisan fashion. You have to remember the last election, the county recorder was a Democrat, but working with the Republican Board of Supervisors. I think you see this split between the Senate, where you have a much more influential right-wing caucus, a caucus that's kind of moved to the right, and the Board of Supervisors, which is maybe more moderate, or not even moderate necessarily, but has simply been put in a position of having to, defend its work and defend, governing, right, at a very local level, kind of staying out of national politics, trying to keep out of national issues, and really just defend day-to-day governance.
So what do we know about the company that's leading this audit, Cyber Ninjas?
We don't know a whole lot, actually. The Senate hired four different companies to work on this audit, and they have experience in the tech world. Nobody seems to have experience working on elections of this magnitude. You have to remember, Maricopa County is one of the biggest counties in the country and has a pretty large and complex election system. So it was, I guess, a bit of a surprise that these companies were chosen. I haven't really heard from election officials who've worked with them before. There was at least one company that works in elections that had offered to work on this and was passed up. I think the Senate had said it would be too expensive to have hired them. But I think that the fact that the Senate hired Cyber Ninjas, which is based out of Florida, hasn't really worked in this space before, hired them for $150,000, raised a lot of concerns too. A lot of election officials that I've talked to have said that they wouldn't expect this to cost $150,000. They would expect it to cost a lot more than that. And they may not even really trust an audit that costs that little. So there's been a big question about who's paying for the rest of this. Cyber Ninjas has disclosed that it is receiving or has received outside funding to do some of this work, but hasn't said where that money is coming from. We haven't necessarily really gotten assurances that we're going to find out where the rest of this money is coming from.
Yeah, you know, Andrew, just looking at their website, they do some ethical hacking, and also they do consult for when it comes to security work. They do not hunt for pieces of bamboo, though, in ballots. So perhaps that was one of the other companies that they hired. Must be a fascinating story for you to cover, but we have to let you go. Andrew Oxford, thank you so much.
Thank you.